Hi friends, Android 20 is out with cool new features that make life easier for developers. I'll cover these in my next videos. For now, this video is for anyone who hasn't seen the differences between Angular 20 and Angular 19. I'll create an Angular 20 app and show you the changes in the command line interface and how the files are structured. Let's get started. I have already updated my Angular to version 20. When I create a new application, the CLI asks a new question. Do you want to create a zoneless application without zone.js? This is still in developer preview feature, but it shows Angular is moving towards a zoneless approach. We get two options, yes or no. Let's choose yes first. The rest of the questions look similar to Angular 19. I'll select the usual options and create the app. So what's different when you choose zoneless? To understand the impact, I'll also create another app, but this time I'll choose no. Now if we compare both apps, I notice three main differences. In package.json, in the zoneless app, zone.js is no longer listed in the dependencies. In angular.json, the polyfills related to zone.js are removed. In app.config.ts, instead of provide zone change reduction, the zoneless app uses provide zoneless change reduction. That's the key difference. In future versions, Angular might make zoneless mode the default without asking. What else changed from Angular 19? The biggest change we can notice is the file naming convention. The .component.part is gone from file names. This is good for CSS and HTML files because from the file extension itself we can understand. However, for TypeScript files, it could cause confusion. For example, if you create a service, you might want to name it some name-service.ts. This applies to pipes, directives, etc. Let's see how the CLI names these files. Oh no, it doesn't add service at the end. That's not ideal. I hope Angular updates this in the next release. If you think this change is intentional, let me know in the comments. Okay, let's also try creating a pipe. For pipe, it's good. Let's try a directive. For directives, again no consistent naming. Seems like there is no standardization yet. Hopefully, they will standardize this in future releases. For now, we can manually rename files to avoid confusion. Okay, apart from this naming convention, let's look at a few more changes. In app.config.ts, a new provider has been added. I'm not sure what it's for yet. We'll explore that later. In package.json, the platform browser dynamic package has been removed since it's deprecated. The CLI builder package has changed from Angular dev kit build Angular to Angular build. In angular.json, all references to the old builder are now updated to the new one. Jasmine has been upgraded to version 5.7 and TypeScript to 5.8.2. Also in angular.json, properties like output path, index, and the scripts array are removed. There are some updates in TypeScript config files too. And in app.ts, a protected access modifier is now used. Maybe Angular is working on better encapsulation features. We'll have to wait and see. And if I start the application, I'm not seeing any change. That's all for today. I hope you found this helpful. I'll be back soon with another interesting topic. Thank you. Bye.